In this video, I'm going to show you how to hook up your Xbox One controller through Bluetooth on a Raspberry Pi. It's not as simple as you think. Stick around because you know what time it is. So I've always been a fan of the Xbox 360 controllers for PC gaming and so forth, and I've loved the fact that you can buy a really cheap Xbox 360 USB controller. But now with the Xbox One out and so forth, there's a few different controllers out there. You can use them through USB, however, using them through Bluetooth wasn't able to be achieved until now. Now, this does only work with the newer Xbox controllers, and they've actually rebranded them to just Xbox Wireless Controller instead of Xbox One Controller. But you will have to jump through a few hoops to get it to work. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel if you're not already, and if you are, make sure you hit that bell icon too, because it helps you to get notified whenever I release a new video. Let's jump over to the Raspberry Pi and we'll see how it works.
So before we get started, you'll need to do a couple of things. Number one, you'll need to update your RetroPie installation. Number two, you'll need to make sure the Xbox One controller you have is the Bluetooth version. Now, the version to look out for is called model 1708. And the way you can figure out what your model version is in the battery compartment behind the batteries, it will have the model number there. And if you've just bought your Xbox One controller and you're sure that it's Bluetooth, one of the things you have to do before you can even use this with the RetroPie installation is you need to hook it up to a Windows 10 PC and go through a firmware update. Now that should be automatic. It will actually do that through Windows Update itself. So once you've done that, you'll be right to use your Xbox One controller on your Raspberry Pi. And lastly, for this tutorial, you will need a keyboard connected to your Raspberry Pi, so make sure you have one handy. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna run through the normal way you would do it, and I'll show you the message you will get, just so you can see it. And then we'll explain how it will actually be fixed and how we can get this working properly. So on your RetroPie installation, what you'll need to do is you'll need to go into the configuration menu and then choose Bluetooth. Once you're in the Bluetooth menu, what you'll need to do is you'll need to choose register and connect to Bluetooth device. Before you press this though, make sure you press the sync button on top of the Xbox One controller. This will search for a little while and eventually it will find your Xbox wireless controller. So if you choose that, and then choose the option number one, which is display yes, no, then you'll come up with this error message. So basically it can't communicate or sync properly, or in this case, pair properly with the Xbox One controller. So this is where the tutorial really starts. So what you'll need to do is you'll need to be in RetroPie and you'll need to press F4 on the keyboard. Once you're at the command prompt, what you'll need to do is you'll need to type in the following: sudo nano slash opt slash RetroPie slash configs slash all slash autostart.sh. This will start up the nano text editor and it will allow us to edit the autostart.sh file. So basically this will automatically start this fix every time we start up the RetroPie installation. So what we'll need to do is we'll need to go to the very start of where it says emulation station with the arrow keys and then press enter so we bring it down to a separate line. Then above that, what we'll do is we'll type in the following, which is sudo bash dash c single quotation mark echo 1 greater than symbol slash sys slash module slash bluetooth slash parameters slash disable underscore ERTM single quotation mark. Now what this does is disables ERTM, which is a mode of Bluetooth. It's not required for the Xbox controller, so it shouldn't affect anything else. All it's for is it's something to do with Wi-Fi, and it's an extra protocol that Bluetooth introduced. So most devices are backwards compatible, so not having it there, it should be fine for other devices. So once we're done in the document, we just need to press Control X, Y, and then Enter. And now we're out of there, we just need to type in Exit to get back to RetroPie. Now before we go any further, I'd highly recommend that you do a reboot, a complete reboot on your RetroPie installation. Once we're back up, we need to go into Configuration and then we need to go into Bluetooth. Once you're in there, you need to go to Register and Connect to a Bluetooth device. Make sure you press the Pair button on top of the Xbox One controller before you go into here. Once you see the device in the list, make sure you select that and choose display yes, no as your security mode. And if everything's gone to plan, it should now say successfully registered and connected. But wait, there's more. You do need to stop here because keep watching as the setup for the actual binding for the keys does not go to plan. So don't quit out on the video just yet. Stick around because I've still got to show you how to do this properly. So once you get back to the main screen, you need to get into the main menu, which is the start button, and you need to get to configure input. And you need to say, yes, you're sure you want to configure the input. Now what you need to do is hold down one of the buttons on the Xbox One controller, and this will recognize that that device is the one that you want to use. Now going through and hitting all the buttons to configure this correctly won't work exactly the first time. So it will work for up, down, left, right, start, select, A, B, X, and Y. But this is where it gets a little bit tricky. For my particular controller and my particular RetroPie installation, the right trigger and the right thumbstick button didn't work for me. So what I had to do after I had gone through the setup is go back up and then redo this again. The second time around, for whatever reason, it worked. So you need to go back up the list, make sure you do select the right trigger and the right thumbstick button, and then go all the way down the bottom and hit OK. And now, every time you reboot your RetroPie installation, it will be properly configured and automatically pair with your Xbox One wireless Bluetooth controller. Awesome!
So after all that, you should now have your Xbox One wireless Bluetooth controller hooked up to your Raspberry Pi. Awesome! So if you stuck around to the end, thanks for that, and thanks for watching my videos. If you are a subscriber, make sure you hit that bell icon. And if you're not a subscriber, make sure you do now because it really helps me a lot. Like this video and let me know how I went down in the comments below. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Oh, and one more thing. Don't forget to like and share this video too because it really helps the channel out a lot. Thanks.